Welcome. Safety is our absolute first priority. Only together can we prevent unsafe situations. That's everyone's responsibility. Know your responsibilities and you'll always stay one step ahead of danger. Awareness of health and safety, the environment and well-being is not a 9-to-5 job. It has to be second nature. As well as the information that has already been harmonized, location and company-specific information also applies. Ask for it. Today, we'd like to draw your attention to mercury. Mercury occurs naturally in gas-containing formations. Mercury is produced to a greater or less degree during the production of natural gas. It may occur as metallic mercury in all production facilities, specifically in pipes, filters, tanks, and glycol units. Mercury may also occur in the sludge from, for example, skimmer tanks. So be careful and cautious. Mercury is a liquid metal and evaporates easily. Another characteristic of mercury is that it's odorless and toxic. So mercury is extremely harmful and dangerous to health and to the environment. Therefore, it's important that you know what personal protection equipment to use. So make sure to use the proper personal protection equipment in the prescribed manner. This is required by law. Keep the personal protection equipment in good condition too. This is how you protect yourself, others, and the environment. The personal protection equipment that you need depends on the concentration of mercury vapor per cubic meter. You measure this with a mercury vapor monitor. The limit value and the action value of mercury is 0.02 milligrams per cubic meter. If the concentration of mercury vapor is less than 0.02 milligrams per cubic meter, use your basic set of personal protection equipment. If the mercury vapor concentration per cubic meter is between 0.02 and 0.04 milligrams, then a full face mask is complementary to the basic protection equipment. The full face mask is called an ABEK HGP3. If the mercury vapor concentration is more than 0.04 milligrams per cubic meter, then only classified personnel may carry out the work. Besides the basic protection equipment, they use independent respiratory protection equipment and a Viton overall. The basic safety gear for operations with mercury is a standard overall, a liquid-proof disposable overall with a polyethylene coating, Viton gloves, safety boots with a PU sole, a safety helmet, and finally, safety glasses. For work involving a specific risk, the supervisor determines the additional protection equipment required. These are specified in the work permit. There are a number of actions that you can take to prevent pollution of mercury. For example, use the leak trays or the decontamination unit. If clothing is contaminated with mercury or possibly contaminated, deposit the clothing with the mercury-containing waste. This also applies to used and sealed filters. Make sure to clean your boots according to the procedures. A certified employee always measures in advance if there is a contamination with mercury. During work, use the proper personal protection equipment, but also ensure good ventilation during work and respect safety zones. You recognize the safety zones by the red and white warning tape. Mercury measurements must be repeated during the day. If you suspect the release of mercury during work, leave the workplace immediately and report the release to the site manager or the supervisor. You can take precautionary measures by ensuring your personal hygiene. For example, always wash your hands with lots of water and soap. Do so before taking a break and before eating and drinking. Do so too before and after going to the toilet, but also before smoking and before leaving the site. Mercury may be released in the event of a leak. If that happens, stop all work immediately and report every leak directly to the permit holder, site manager or supervisor. One of the dangers associated with mercury is the breathing of vapors. These vapors are extremely toxic and may cause respiratory irritation. But breathing these toxic vapors can also have serious consequences. For example, chemical pneumonia, allergic reactions, disturbance of the nervous system, changes in behavior and brain functioning. But it also affects the reproductive system, harm to the unborn child, and danger of cumulative effects. If someone has breathed mercury vapor, bring the victim into the open for fresh air. Make sure he gets plenty of rest. Carry out mechanical resuscitation if necessary. So do not use mouth-to-mouth resuscitation. Skin contact is another danger. Mercury can be absorbed through the skin. It can be irritating to the skin, but it can also cause allergic reactions. In this case, you must remove contaminated clothing and wash the skin with lots of water and soap. Eye contact is also one of the dangers of mercury. It can be irritating to the eyes and cause allergic reactions. Flush your eyes with lots of water or eye fluid. If you wear contact lenses, remove them. Finally, ingestion of mercury is very dangerous because it's extremely toxic. It irritates or can even harm your health and cause allergic reactions. If someone has ingested mercury and is conscious, rinse his mouth with water. Do not induce vomiting. Be responsible. Immediately notify the medic in all cases. For questions or further information, you can turn to your supervisor. And remember, work safely or do not work at all. Good luck.